Imagine if getting lost became a thing of the past. Even finding lost keys would no longer feel like a lost cause.
What we're trying to study is when you get around in the world, your day-to-day environments, how is it that you learn them?
With support from the National Science Foundation, cognitive psychologist Amy Shelton explores our brain's navigation system.
Okay, let's make sure that we get this cleanly.
Okay.
And that we get good coverage of the hippocampus.
Scott Clark is having his head examined. In this demonstration, Shelton uses an MRI to analyze blood flow in his brain as he learns his way through a virtual world.
He's watching a movie of an observer moving around, and as the observer moves around, you see these items pop up. There's a shopping cart, a tree, and the job is to learn where in the environment those items are located.
Later, Scott takes an easy retrieval test, and that reveals hard evidence about how he learns the world around him. Does he make a map in his head, a so-called place learner, or does he follow the same route he watched over and over again, like a creature of habit, a response learner?
And what we look for is, are they taking the shortcuts or are they sticking to their familiar path? And this tends to be very then diagnostic. So if he's taking the detours, we would say he's probably going to be a place learner. If he tends to use the familiar path, then we call him a response learner because he's sticking to that sort of set of actions that will get him to the same place over and over again.
Shelton analyzes the MRI images and can easily distinguish place learners from response learners.
This region here in the hippocampus is more active, or sort of pops up, for people who are showing place learning on that test, who are taking detours, who are using space more flexibly. Whereas the caudate here is more active for people who are these creatures of habit, using the familiar routes over and over again.
Shelton says this research could help us develop better memory techniques.
By understanding the different kinds of learning mechanisms, and in particular what kinds of advantages and disadvantages each type of learning conveys, we can start to do things like tailor people's GPS systems to play to their advantages.
And that could mean getting lost might one day get a whole lot harder. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.